means how much. And so remember, 1 gram atom, 1 gram atom of calcium corresponds to 40 gram. Then 1.5 gram atom of calcium corresponds to 40 multiplied by 1.5 divided by 1. And so 40 multiplied by 1.5, that is equal to 60. That is equal to 60 gram. And thus remember, what is mass of 1.5 gram atom of calcium? So mass of 1.5 gram atom of calcium, that is corresponds to 60 gram, equal to 60 gram. Now second, again we have to calculate mass of 2.5 gram atom aluminium. So here atomic mass. Now atomic mass of aluminium, it is equal to 27 gram per mole. Now 2.5 gram atom of aluminium, again remember same concept, 1 gram atom of aluminium corresponds to or equal to 27 gram, because 27 is the atomic mass of aluminium. And so 1 gram atom of aluminium corresponds to 27 gram. Then 2.5 gram atom of aluminium corresponds to 27 multiplied by 2.5 divided by 1. And so which is equal to, then and so which is equal to then 67.5. And so 67.5, this is mass of 2.5 gram atom of aluminium. Then let us consider the next example. We have to calculate the mass of 2.5 gram molecule of water. Mass of 2.5 gram molecule. Mass of 2.5 gram molecule of water. Now molar mass. So here molar mass of water, it is equal to 2 plus 16, that is 18 gram per mole. Now molar mass of water, that is 18 gram per mole, we have to calculate mass of 2.5 gram molecule of water. Now then again same concept, 1 gram molecule, it is also considered as 1 gram mole. So 1 gram molecule or 1 gram mole of H2O, it is corresponds to its gram molar mass, that is equal to 18 gram. So 1 gram molecule or 1 gram mole of water corresponds to its gram molar mass, that is 18. And so then 2.5 gram molecule, 2.5 gram molecule of water, it is equal to then 2.5 multiplied by 18 divided by 1. And so remember 45 gram. And so remember, what is mass of 2.5 gram molecule of water? Mass of 2.5 gram molecule of water, that is equal to 45 gram. Now, the next problem, again, all problems related to the most important concept, that is mole concept. Now, calculate, next problem, problem number fifth or sixth, calculate the number of moles, calculate number of moles, molecules. Calculate number of moles, number of molecules, and total atoms present in. Calculate number of moles, number of molecules, and total atoms present in 0.0049 gram sulfuric acid. Now in this problem, molar mass of sulfuric acid is given, and so molar mass of sulfuric acid, it is equal to 98 gram per mole. Now we have to calculate three values, number of moles, number of molecules, and number of atoms present in 0.0049 in terms of kilogram. Here mass is given in kilogram and not gram, in kilogram. So we have to calculate number of moles, number of molecules, and number of atoms present in 0.0049 kilogram of sulfuric acid. Now then, first we have to calculate the number of moles. Then what is formula? Number of moles is equal to mass in kilogram given mass. Remember, here mass is given in kilogram, mass in kilogram upon molar mass of that substance in kilogram. So remember, if mass is expressed in kilogram, then molar mass is also expressed in kilogram, and so which is equal to, it is 0.0049 divided by 98. Now this 98 gram, it is converted into kilogram, so 98 into 10 raised to minus 3, or which is equal to, so 49 into 10 raised to minus 3. So 49, actually it is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. So 49 into 10 raised to minus 4. So 0.00449. 10 raised to minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. So 49 into 10 raised to minus 4 divided by 98 into 10 raised to minus 3. And so which is equal to then 49 divided by 98. Now this 10 raised to minus 3 goes numerator, plus 3 and minus 4, that is 10 raised to minus 1. And thus remember, 49 upon 98, that is 1 by 2 means 0.5, and so it is equal to 0.5 multiplied by 10 raised to minus 1, or which is equal to 0.05 mole. And thus remember, number of mole present in 0.0045 kilogram of sulfuric acid, that is 0.05 mole. So number of moles, it is equal to 0.05. Then second, we have to calculate number of molecules. Now how to calculate number of molecules from number of moles? Again, there is a relationship between number of moles and number of molecules. Remember, number of moles number of molecules is equal to number of moles multiplied by Avogadro's number. So this is simple relationship. So number of molecules is equal to number of moles of that substance multiplied by Avogadro's number. And thus remember, number of molecules of sulfuric acid. So number of molecules of sulfuric acid is equal to number of moles of sulfuric acid. Now number of moles of sulfuric acid calculated, that is equal to 0.05. 0.05, it means 5 × 10⁻²⁻² into Avogadro's number, 6.022 × 10⁻²⁷. And thus 5 × 10⁻²⁷ into 6.022 × 10⁻²⁷. Now we have to multiply this. So this 6.022 multiplied by 5. And so it is 31.110 into, now this is 10⁻²⁷ and this is 10⁻². So it is 10⁻²+21. And thus remember, number of molecules present in 0.05 mole sulfuric acid, that is 31.110 into 10⁻²⁷. So these are the molecules present in 0.0049 kilogram sulfuric acid, kilogram. Now then also we have to calculate total number of atoms. Now what is the molecular formula? Remember, molecular formula of sulfuric acid. So molecular formula of sulfuric acid, that is H2SO4. Now as a molecular formula of sulfuric acid is H2SO4, it indicates that one molecule of sulfuric acid consists two atom of hydrogen, one atom of sulfur and four atom of oxygen. And so remember, total atoms present in one molecule of sulfuric acid. So total atoms present in one molecule of sulfuric acid, that is equal to 7. So 2 + 1 = 3, 3 + 4 = 7. And as we know the number of atoms present in one molecule, you can calculate the total number of atoms present in 31.11 × 10⁻²⁷ molecules. Now one molecule of H2SO4 corresponds to 7 atoms. And then 31.11 × 10⁻²⁷ molecules of sulfuric acid. So it corresponds to 7 × 31.11 × 10⁻²⁷ / 1. And so remember, these are the total number of atoms present in 31.11 × 10⁻²⁷ molecules of sulfuric acid. So total atoms. Now again consider some different example related to again mole concept. Next, the mass of 200 ml of certain gas. Now, mass of 200 ml of certain gas is 0.392 gram, 0.392 gram. Mass of 200 ml of certain gas, it is 0.392 gram. Now, then, at STP, calculate molar mass of gas. Calculate molar mass of gas. Now, remember, so gas is unknown. So, mass of 200 ml of that gas is equal to 0.392 gram. Then we have to calculate the molar mass of gas. Now, this problem is related to the fourth concept of mole. That is gram molar volume and mole. What is gram molar volume? It is the volume occupied by one mole gas. And you know that gram molar volume of any gas, it is equal to 22.41 decimeter cube. Or approximately 22.4 decimeter cube at STP. Now 22.4 decimeter cube corresponds to 22,400 ml. And so we know that gram molar volume of any gas is 22.4 decimeter cube. Or which is also equal to 22,400 ml at STP. Now, this problem based on this concept. So, gram molar volume of any gas, it is 22.4 decimeter cube at STP. Now, in this problem, volume is given in ml, and thus we have to consider here gram molar volume in ml, and thus remember, mass of 200 ml of gas is equal to 0.392 gram at STP. Now, mass of 200 ml of gas is 0.392 gram at STP. We have to calculate gram molar mass. It means we have to calculate the mass of 22,400 ml of gas. And thus remember, we have to calculate mass of 22,400 ml gas at STP. So, which is equal to then 0.392 multiplied by 22,400 ml upon 200. This is in terms of gram. And thus it is equal to 0.392. Now, this 2 0 cancel, 0.392 multiplied by 224 upon 2, or it is also equal to 0.392 multiplied by, now when you divide this by, then it is 112. And so when you calculate this, when you multiply 0.392 by 112, then it is equal to 44. So when you calculate this, it is 44. So it is 44 gram. And thus remember, mass of 22,400 ml of that gas, it is equal to 44 gram at STP. And thus remember, molar mass of gas, it is 44. So, molar mass of gas, it is equal to then 44 gram. Now, when it is expressed in gram, that is a gram molar mass. So, it is 44 gram. Now, the next problem related to again mole concept. Next problem related to mole concept. Calculate the number of calculate the number of molecules, comma, number of atoms. Calculate number of molecules, comma, number of atoms present in number of atoms present in 11.2 decimeter cube of oxygen at STP. Now very simple problem, again related to gram molar volume. Now we have to calculate the number of molecules and number of atoms present in 11.2 decimeter cube of oxygen. Now here always remember, what is gram molar volume? It is the volume occupied by 1 gram mole of gas. And in case of oxygen, you know, molar mass of oxygen is 32. 16 plus 16 is the atomic mass. So molar mass is 32. And volume occupied by 32 gram of oxygen at STP, that is 22.4 decimeter cube. Now, then experimentally it is observed that remember, the number of molecules present in 22.4 decimeter cube oxygen, it is always equal to Avogadro's number, that is 6.022 10^23 at STP. STP or NTP. It means 22.4 decimeter cube of oxygen consists Avogadro's number of molecules. Then number of molecules present in 11.2 decimeter cube oxygen, it is equal to, yes, so number of molecule present in 22.4, so 22.4 corresponds this value, then this corresponds to how much, and so which is equal to then 11.2 multiplied by 6.022 10^23 divided by 22.4. and thus remember, so it is exactly 1/2. And so the number of molecule present, that is 6.022 10^23 divided by 2. And thus it is equal to 3.011 × 10^23. So what are the number of molecules present in this 11.2 decimeter cube of oxygen at STP? That is 3.011 × 10^23. That is the half of the gram molar volume. And then we have to calculate the number of atoms. Now what is molar formula, what is molecular formula of oxygen? So molecular formula of oxygen, molecular formula of oxygen is O2. Molecular formula of oxygen is O2. Now it indicates that one molecule of oxygen, it consists two atoms of oxygen. Now one molecule corresponds to two atoms, then these number of molecules corresponds to how much? And thus remember, one molecule of oxygen is equal to two atoms of oxygen. Then 3.011 × 10^23 molecules corresponds to 2 × 10^23. So that is equal to 6.022 × 10^23 atoms. And thus remember, number of atoms present in 11.2 decimeter cube of oxygen, that is equal to the Avogadro's number, that is 6.022 × 10^20. These are the number of atom present in 11.2 decimeter cube of oxygen. Now, and last problem, calculate the number of atoms. Calculate the number of atoms of each element. Calculate the number of atoms of each element. Number of atoms of each element present in. Number of atoms of each element present in 5.3 gram sodium carbonate. 5.3 gram sodium carbonate. Now molar mass of sodium carbonate Na2CO3, that is equal to 106 gram per mole. Now we have to calculate the number of each atoms present in 5.3 gram sodium carbonate. Now to calculate the number of each atoms present in 5.3 gram of sodium carbonate, first we have to calculate the number of molecules. To calculate the number of molecules of sodium carbonate, we have to again calculate the number of mole of sodium carbonate. And thus remember, the number of mole of sodium carbonate that is equal to mass of sodium carbonate in gram, that is 5.3, upon its molar mass in gram, that is 106, or which is equal to, so it is 53 × 10^-1 divided by 106, and so it is 1/2, it means 0.5, and so which is equal to then 5 × 10^-2. 0.5 × 10^-1 or 5 × 10^-2, and thus 5.3 gram sodium carbonate corresponds to 5 × 10^-2 mole. Then so we calculate number of moles, then we calculate the number of molecules. Number of molecules is equal to, so what is formula of number of molecules? Number of molecules is equal to number of moles multiplied by Avogadro's number. So this is the relationship. Number of molecules is equal to number of moles of that substance multiplied by its Avogadro's number. And thus it is equal to, now number of moles of sodium carbonate, that is 5 × 10^-2 multiplied by 6.022 × 10^23. So number of molecules is equal to number of moles multiplied by Avogadro's number. And so it is 5 × 6.022 × 10^20, that is 31.11. So this multiplication into, now 10^23 and minus, that is 10^21. So these are the total molecules present. So these are the total molecules. So total molecules present in 5.3 gram sodium carbonate. Now then we have to calculate total atoms of each element. Total atoms of each element. Now here, what is the molar formula, what is molecular formula of sodium carbonate? So molecular formula of sodium carbonate, it is Na2CO3. Molecular formula. And so, as a molecular formula of sodium carbonate is Na2CO3, it indicates that one molecule of sodium carbonate consists two atoms of sodium. And thus, one molecule of sodium carbonate consists two atoms of sodium, because molecular formula is Na2CO3. So there are two atoms of sodium. Now one molecule corresponds to two atoms, then 31.11 into 10 raised to 21 molecules of sodium carbonate corresponds to how much? And so which is equal to 2 multiplied by 31.11 10 raised to 21 divided by 1. So these are the total atoms of sodium. So these are total atoms of sodium present in 5.6 gram of sodium carbonate. Then second, one molecule of sodium carbonate consists one atom of carbon, because molecular formula is Na2CO3. Then 31.11 into 10 raised to 21 molecules of sodium carbonate corresponds, or it consists one multiplied by 31.11 into 10 raised to 21 atoms of carbon. And last, third, we have to calculate total atoms of oxygen. Now here Na2CO3 indicate that one molecule of sodium carbon consists how many atoms of oxygen? 3 atoms. And so one molecule of sodium carbonate consists three atoms of oxygen. So one molecule of sodium carbonate consists 3 atoms of oxygen, then 31.11 into 10 raised to 21 molecules of sodium carbonate consist how many atoms? 3 multiplied by 31.11 into 10 raised to 21 divided by 1. So these are the total atoms of oxygen present in these 31.11 into 10 raised to 21 molecules of sodium carbonate. So these are the some problems. They are related to most important concept, that is mole concept of this topic. Yes.